I met Vuyo in 1996. I remember very well, it was in December of 1996. I was going to see my grandmother in Soweto, Zone 9, Midlands. And Vuyo had meter taxis there by North Street. And yeah, I was passing and he was standing there with a bunch of taxi owners. And they called me and I got so nervous. And I wasn't even aware that he was the one who called me, and they asked for my number. It was like 10 or 15 of them. And they surrounded me, they put me inside a circle, and I thought, I just need to get out of this place. Why did I give them a correct number? Only God knows. I just gave my number, not even knowing who am I giving it to. Then I went home. And I think a week passed. After a week, I received a call. And it was this nice, mellow voice. And I didn't know who it was, so I was so curious. I got very curious and I wanted to know who is this person. Then I gave him direction to where I was staying. We were staying in Fort Lauderdale then with my parents. And then he came the next day, if I'm not mistaken, and I saw this tall and handsome a man with a ponytail. I remember he had a very huge ponytail. And I thought, I know this face. And yeah, he told me that he's a singer, he's a musician, and he's very interested in me. And I got so excited because he was a celebrity. And I went around telling my friend that I met this tall and good-looking man. And he drove this beautiful Kusheshe. Remember those days, they called it a Kusheshe BM, a red one. Full blast music. I could hear him coming when he was around the corner. And I started telling my friends about him. And yeah, they said, no, he's not serious about me because he's getting married to Rebecca. And I asked him, what's happened? What's going on between you and Rebecca? And it happened that around those days, they had a show in Katlehong. So he asked me to go with him to the show, a concert. Then we went. But the first thing when he got there, he just took me backstage. And he took me to meet Rebecca. And we went there. Rebecca was sitting there with her band members. And the only thing we said was that, Malup, look at her, you see now? She says, I'm getting married to you. Tell her that we're not getting married. We're just sisters and we're twins. And Rebecca just laughed. She did not say anything. She just laughed. And that's when I met Vuyo. We dated for about 2 years. Then he asked the big question, and I could not believe. I did not believe him. I could not believe that he chose me over a lot of women, and it was not easy. Because he was well known and very attractive and handsome and talented, and I know that the competition was very tough. So when he asked me to marry him, I could not believe my eyes and my ears, and I thought he was not serious. But when we received a letter from his parents in Duduza, that's when I knew that yeah, he's really changed and he wants us to get married. And we married 2 years after, 2008, got married. It was not a big wedding, we just did a small wedding, and he invited his friends. Jabu was there, Jabu Hlongwane, and Avante, Percy Ing, a lot of his friends were there. And that's how we met and that's how we got married. We had a small, beautiful wedding at my place. By then we were staying in Rondebelt, and that's when we got married, yeah. Hallelujah.